Hello, and welcome to the 1061 Season in Review.
We are ecstatic that you have taken the time out of your busy schedules to join us for our Season in Review show.
Good evening, I'm Shawn Wilson, competitor and co-announcer at 1061 Speedway.
And I'm Nick Cupolo. I'm also a competitor here at 1061 Speedway, and I would say I'm the head announcer here for the weekly videos. Shawn, how are you doing this off-season?
It's been real busy. Coaching hockey, getting the go-kart all tuned up. You know, just trying to stay busy. How about you, Nick?
I heard that, I'll answer that question in a second, but I heard that you completely stripped your car and you're having it powder coated?
That is correct.
Who's doing that for you?
There's a place on Allenport Road. Can't think of the name right now.
Oh, that's unfortunate. We could have gave him a plug. To answer, how am I doing? I'm doing well. All the go-karts are sitting in the garage exactly the way they were left. I think the rental carts are getting a couple fresh motors for next year to hopefully keep up with the Knapp clan.
Yeah, the Knappers.
Who were setting fast times all year. Hopefully the rental carts will be a little bit more competitive next year.
Well, I'm sure they will. They always are.
So, Shawn, any other exciting news coming your way from the offseason?
Yeah, actually, we just got engaged, me and my girlfriend Paige.
Okay.
And we just had our firstborn.
Really?
No.
Shawn is always the jokester. He's the one you hear up in the booth making all the people laugh. All right, so now that we're done with the pleasantries, we're going to send it to a small clip of the winners that we had here this past 2016 season.
Take it away.
And the winner's Hove, my man. Speech.
Shut up. Leading the way with 8 wins, Brett the Carpet King Stratford.
With 5 wins in the 2016 season, Steve Smokey Robeson.
And with 3 wins, Thorold Thunder, Nick Cupolo.
With 2 wins, Grandpa Tom Downey in the number 93.
And with 1 win, the Hoosier Hucker and Pride of Port Robinson, Kevin Knapp.
Also with 1 win, the 08, Sean the Cart Whisperer Wilson.
Also with 1 win, the Ginger Ninja, Anton Jensen.
Jeff Nightshade Morningstar also took a win in 2016.
And rounding out the wins, 1 win, Tyler, the Polish Hammer, Polchaski.
Shut up! Wow, that was quite the recap of all of last year's winners. I know we made a lot of people happy in 2016. One that stood out, Anton Jensen. Apparently that was his first ever win in any form of motorsports.
Yeah, he had a great rookie season.
He did, and he almost won our All-Star Night in mid-July, but I think he came about 2 points short. He was really devastated after that. I don't think he showed his face here for another month.
Yeah. It was good to see Papa Jensen come out and race with the rental car too. He had a blast.
Agreed. Now on to our next segment. Shawn, lead us into that.
Well, it's the incident that rocked the racing world. The Adam Leslie incident.
Full disclosure, what you are about to see may affect you. Parental discretion advised.
Story is for Kenny Brick.
And I would suspect you're going to have to run, Gary, because you're going to be in there fairly quickly. Brack picks up the lead. Oh, and Zanardi. Oh, with a terrible crash. Yellow is out.
Wow, what a tragedy. He is lucky to be alive.
Yeah, that was quite the scene back in May. I'd just like to thank again all the people who helped take care of that event and got Adam the proper care and to the place that he needed to be quickly and efficiently.
You guys are the real heroes.
I was able to talk to Adam and his father this past week, and we discussed what life has been like since that fateful day. I'd like to say thanks again to Adam and his father Ken for allowing me the time to take a peek into their lives since that cold May evening.
Yeah, and now on a happier note, we're going to get to some off-season awards. The first being the most improved driver. You know who that was, Nick?
No, I have no idea.
Anton Jensen,
number three out on the track, number one in your hearts. Won his first feature in 2016.
Yep. He had a hell of a year.
Funny story how we got introduced to Anton. Well, that's not that funny, but I posted a body for sale on Kijiji.
That body?
No, it was a go-kart body, Shawn. Mm. And he saw the track out there when he came to pick it up, and we've been in contact ever since, and Anton is a valued member of the 1061 Speedway group.
Yeah, he travels an hour to get here every Wednesday?
From Burlington, Ontario.
Wow.
Yeah, down the QEW every Wednesday.
That's dedication.
Next on our off-season awards, we're giving away the most cheeriest award.
Ooh.
Shawn, any predictions on to who can take that one?
Al?
No, unfortunately, he gets grumpy sometimes, so that brings him down the rankings.
Oh.
We're giving this one to Sheldon Sulman. Sheldon, owner of Sheldon Homes, he frequently rented the rental car and once told me that driving a go-kart has made him feel the most alive that he has ever been.
Wow. Well, he is 90 years old.
Yeah, that's... Every time Sheldon gets out of that cart, he has a huge smile on his face, and we love seeing it, let me tell you.
Yeah. Great companion.
Right now. Who is this, my man?
This is Sheldon. Take him for an interview.
How you doing, buddy?
Sheldon's feeling great. He's nervous right now, and that's the way he should be. Start of a great race. And the temperature reminds me of when I used to race in Italy in Monza. That was really hot. Monza,
oh, yeah.
You know,
hot.
You know, hot.
Sheldon's got this one tonight, folks. Let's get out there and get him.
Sheldon,
attaboy!
And now, for our next award.
Most eligible to appear on The Bachelor Canada. We're giving this one to Matt Sharp. Matt drove the 5, or it might have been the 55, or could have even been the 555, as him and his family brought 3 carts here at the end of 2016. In those brief appearances he made at the end of the season, damn, did he look good.
You can find that heartthrob blasting cigarettes every Wednesday here at 1061 Speedway.
That's right, Sean. Although I believe we race every other Wednesday.
That is correct.
And now, Sean, tell us about the last award that we're giving out here for the 2016 season.
The last award is the 2016 1061 Woman of the Year. The winner of that award this year is Christine Burden.
Christine broke the record in 2016 of most Facebook stalkers. Previously, Briar Hanley held that record at 4, but Christine blew that out of the water in 2016 with 13 Facebook stalkers, courtesy of 1061 Speedway.
Wow. Great job, Christine.
That's an incredible number, and I'm sure we'll have plenty of ladies looking to flaunt their stuff and beat that record in the coming season.
Let's hope so. Final segment, the racers we said goodbye to in
Shawn, look at the spots you've got on the varnish. Zerk's gonna be pissed. Let me get you a coaster. Can you hold this, please?
Don't eat it.
Now with 2016 wrapped up here at 1061 Speedway, we are excitedly looking forward to the 2017 season. Shawn, tell us what we're going to learn about first.
Well, we're going to send it to Tera in the garage with some exciting news for 2017.
Ooh, I can't wait to see and hear what it is.
Okay, everyone, friends, near and far, this is the big news. this couch. Look at this couch. Is everyone as excited about it as I am? Obviously you can't feel it like I'm feeling it, but this is top quality, genuine leather. This couch is here for us, for everyone to use. A 1061 Speedway 2017 season. Whoa. So, what are we gonna do with it? What's gonna happen? I don't know. Okay, so we're planning on putting this couch trackside for the 2017 season. And what I want everyone to remember is that this is a Roy Hill leather couch that was purchased from Ashley Furniture, straight out of their 2017 collection. And I mean, would you expect anything less from us here at 1061 Speedway? No, I don't think so. The answer is no. So my next question is, who is gonna be the new sponsor of this beautiful couch in 2017? I mean, what better thing to sponsor than a couch at 1061 Speedway? Think about it, people. This is where your money needs to go. We can like set up a sign beside it to promote your business. You know, it's gonna get a lot of media press attention. So, I mean, first come, first serve, like really. So you can just submit your offers. Okay, so management here at 1061 Speedway is in the final decisions of where we're gonna put this couch during the season. So we're thinking in turn four, up on the hill, or it could be in the infield as well. So there's pros and cons to each, and the infield is more of like a prestigious thing, like, oh, we're gonna go watch on the infield, like, so much fun. But from turn four, you get a much better view, and you also wouldn't get vertigo. So, really, what we want to do is we want to ask you, our beloved fans and friends, and drivers too, staff, volunteers, sponsors, really, where do you want to see this couch? Where do you want to sit in this couch? Turn four or in the infield? Let us know on social media. Just get at us. Are we done?
Yeah, we're good.
Perfect. Ugh. I can't. Oh. What is it? This couch is bullshit. Oh, oh God. Okay.
Wow, what a beautiful couch. Uncle Paul will be happy to get the change out of that every other Thursday morning.
That Italian leather looks like it would be divine to pluck my ass down on. Shawn, where would you most like to see that couch in the 2017 season?
Well, I don't want vertigo, so I like it in turn four, up on the bank.
I can see the positives for both scenarios. Maybe we can try it at one place and then put it in the other and see what the fans like more.
I like it. Hit us up at social media, at 1061 Speedway on Twitter.
You can't hit us up on Facebook because the group is private because we don't want randoms coming up. Our next segment is entitled Buy or Sell. Me and Shawn will talk about four topics and we will either agree to buy or sell. If we buy it, we're pressing this button. If we sell it, I'm not sure, Shawn. Can we maybe throw a couple of your $20 bills in the fire?
No.
Yeah, okay, that works too. Our first topic is the rule changes coming to 1061 Speedway in 2017. So far, the only one that is confirmed is we're gonna have a minimum weight of 350 pounds.
I'm working on that in the off season.
Shawn, what do you think that will bring to the competition here at 1061?
I think it's going to tighten up competition a lot more. We're going to see a lot better racing, and I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, that's just the goal, to try to make the field even more even than it was in previous years. So, Shawn, are we buying or selling that rule change?
I buy.
I agree. We're buying.
That was easy.
Next up, we're going to... Actually, Shawn, why don't you talk about this one?
Next up, we have in the buy or sell the Middle Miss clan returning to 1061 Speedway.
You know, Shawn, they have threatened this threatened appearances in the past 2 years. I'm not sure when they last showed up, 2014 or 2015. But it seems to never work out for them in the end. What do you think the odds are that they show up in 2017?
I'm going to say slim to none, even though they say they're going to come. Joe, I don't see it happening.
All right, well, you can take that as a challenge, you Middle Miss boys, and we would love to have you back in 2017. We're selling this.
So.
All right, our next topic concerns Steve Robeson.
Oh, Steve.
Yeah, Steve. That's the reaction most people have when they hear his name. Simply, does Steve Robeson forget how to follow a rule in 2017?
Do you think he forgets, or he's just badass and doesn't want to do them?
He just forgets, and we're going to buy this.
Yeah. Go and hit the pylon, Steve. No,
what a guy. Lastly, Shawn, what are we going to talk about?
Lastly, Kevin Longo. Kevin said he was going to be here every week last year. I think we saw him, a handful of times?
Yeah,
maybe three?
Two or three at the beginning of the season, and then I think he showed up to the 1060-150 at the end.
Yeah.
This usually happens when Kevin Longo has a girlfriend, and seeing his mother at the Tim Knapp Stag and Doe, she confirmed reports that this is indeed what has happened. Kevin Longo loves women, and when he has one, they take up a lot of his time.
Mm-hmm.
So what prospects do you have for Kevin's relationship in 2017? And are we buying or selling his return?
I'm definitely selling his return. As for predictions of Kevin next year, I predict marriage and at least two babies.
So yes, those two things would definitely prevent him from reappearing here at 1061 Speedway in the upcoming season.
Mm-hmm.
Sad, but true.
And now we're gonna throw it to Tera Knapp, who's gonna tell us about all the new drivers for 2017.
I hear there are a couple hot shoes taking over some rides.
Absolutely.
So first up, we have Joey Mastroianni. He's making his triumphant return to go-karts in 2017. He rented one in 2016, but we're glad to have him back this year. He raced Sportsman and Mod Lights previously, and he has just purchased a new house and is engaged to Adam Leslie's wonderful sister, Kristen.
Joey Mastroianni,
and of course, we wish them all
the
best. The
red lights are on.
Okay, next we have Sean Iftani, one of my personal favorites. He often came and ate CNC Racing's food from the trailer in the late 2000s. He's taking over Jamie Porter's ride in 2017. So I watched Sean get hammered for the first time ever on Christmas Day this year at Billy Bleach's house. It was quite the sloppy spectacle, but good for you, bud. And lastly, we have Rob Esliger. Rob makes venison pepperettes because he hates deer and wants to see them all die. He has a pet chihuahua named Minnow who loves to play with my dog Trax. And I believe we have confirmed that he still double dips his vegetables at parties. And we are glad to have him here in the new season.
This next segment, we are titling The Confidence Meter. We're going to talk about four topics and assess them a confidence level, basically from 1 to 4. But how we're going to discuss them is, most of you know Chris Bain, multi-talented supporter here at 1061 Speedway. He can flag if we need him. He can bring coffee and pizza and to go get that if we need that. He can be in the infield and put tires back where they're supposed to be. Just whatever we need him to do, Chris never complains. He just goes and does it. Another feature of Chris Bain is his customary winter beard. So if me and Shawn think that something is not that likely to happen, we're not too confident in it, we're going to give it a November Chris Bain beard rating. So that would be like a 1 out of 4. If we think something's 2 out of 4, we're going to give it a December Chris Bain beard rating. 3 out of 4, a January Chris Bain beard rating. And if we're really confident in something, we're going to give it a 4 out of 4, which will be a February Chris Bain beard rating.
Say that 10 times fast.
Unlike the previous segment, me and Shawn can disagree on a topic. The last segment, we both combined our opinions into what we thought. But this one, we're going to be free to think what we want.
And on to our next subject. We are proud to announce the ladies' race will be back in 2017.
Wait, no, we were supposed to discuss if it's going to actually happen, Shawn.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, come on.
Cut. And lastly, on the Chris Bain beard reading. We have whether or not the 2017 season will include another ladies' race.
You know, Shawn, the ladies' race has been on the edge of calamity. Turn your phone off, Shawn.
My streak won.
Okay, but for real.
And now, for our final thoughts. I predict the 2017 season to be a very robust one. I think I can see Anthony D'Ortono and Shawn Iftadi coming to blows over the last slice of pizza. How about you, Nick?
Yes, we know that there's always a pizza for the volunteers here at 1061 Speedway every Wednesday. But I feel like Shawn could really weasel his way in there for a slice at the end of the night.
Yeah, especially if he's been drinking. Because as Tera pointed out earlier, he is one sloppy drunk.
That is true. Me and Shawn both also witnessed that firsthand. And now for my final thought. Shawn earlier talked about Kevin Longo impregnating his current girlfriend Erin in the upcoming 2017 calendar year. I'm going to double down on that and say Tera Knapp announces that she's an expecting mother this coming year. Could it be with Kevin Longo in an extramarital announcing fling of the century? It certainly would take all the tabloids and the media would go crazy. But my money is on longtime loving husband Kevin Knapp. I think him and Tera will welcome a wonderful baby boy at the end of 2017. And now me and Shawn, I think we're both out of drink.
It's been a good ride.
So with that being said, we thank you for joining us. Shawn,
I look forward to seeing you all this coming spring.
Me as well.